start sitting up for a few moments. So sit in a comfortable way. Rest your hands on your knees, close your eyes. Start to connect to Ujjayi breath. Making that gentle sound in your throat as you breathe in and out. Increasing flexibility, while at the same time staying as calm and as relaxed as possible. Best way to do it is to keep breathing mindfully, slowly, continuously. When you're ready, bring the palms together in front of your heart, interlace your fingers and breathing, open the eyes. And as you exhale, reach the arms all the way up, taking a big stretch here, lift the chin up, look up to the ceiling, take a deep breath there. Then lean towards your side, lean towards your right, and extend the left arm and over. Keep the hand where it is, or adjust it, take it a bit further back. Take another breath in. Another exhalation. Inhale, come back to the center of the chart. Left hand to the floor by your side, lean towards the left. So modify here, adjust the hand. Maybe bring the elbow to the floor, relax the head, release the jaw. Back to the center, sitting up as you breathe in. Open the arms wide, now turn towards the left. Turn as much as you can. Put the center in, the palms are pointing up, turn towards the right. Then back to the center, reach both arms up. And sweep the hands behind, interlace the fingers behind your back. Press the knuckles to the floor and lift the heart up. You can keep the chin down or you can reach the head up and over. Take a deep breath in. And a long exhalation. Take another breath there. And then again exhale. Relax yourself down. Bring your hands onto your knees and start to lean backwards. So pull your belly and your chest as far back as you can. Until you're almost falling back. Stretch your back. Then sit tall. Once more, reach the arms up as you inhale, bring the palms together and bring the hands to the heart as you exhale. Okay, so we're going to start working with the side of the body. We're starting in the plank. So take yourself into a plank. Hold it as straight as you can. Just for a moment, collapse your chest down, keeping your arms straight, and then lift your chest up. Hold it here, drop the feet towards the right until your hips are as stacked as possible. Hold it here, we're holding 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Bring your hip to the floor, then bring yourself back up, 5, hip to the floor, come back up, 4, hip down, and 3, hip down, and 2, down, and 1, hold it here, reach your left arm up, choose to stay here, if you want to go deeper, take your right knee towards your right elbow, either way, we're holding 5, 4, maybe look up, 3, 2, and 1, both hands down, pull back, downward facing dog. Then other side, so come forwards. Drop the feet to the left. Drop the left hip towards the floor, holding here 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hip to the floor, pick up 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Hold, reach the right arm up, stay here, or left knee to left elbow, holding here 5, lift the gaze, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Downward facing dog. Take a breath in. Then come forwards to a plank. Keeping the toes tucked under, we're taking the modified upward dog. So drop the hips forward. Keep the knees off the floor. Pull back to a tucked plank. One. Release down, inhale. Come up. Two. Release down, inhale. And three. And four. And five. Hold it here. We count to five. Shift the weight forwards. Four. Three. Wrap the triceps. Two. And one. Downward facing dog. Reaching your right leg up to the sky as you inhale. Bend the knee and open up your hip. Then switch. Left leg goes up as you inhale. Bend the knee, open up your hip. Breathe into the left side of your body. And back to downward facing dog. Come forwards to a plank as you inhale. Drop your knees down. Bend the elbows, rest yourself on your belly. With the inhalation, come up to a cobra. Hold it here for a moment. Draw the hands back, lift the chest forward, inhale, and ease yourself down. Tucking the toes, coming through plank or tabletop as you inhale, and back to downward facing dog. Sending your right leg up to the sky as you inhale, now place the foot all the way between the hands. Lift the heart, look forward as you inhale, and step back to downward facing dog, exhale. Again, reach the leg up as you breathe in and bring the foot to the hands as you breathe out. Look forward, inhale, and step back to downward facing dog. Exhale. Take two breaths here. Relax your head. Last breath here. Then bend the knees, look forward. Another step or hop forward. Come to the front of your mat, big toes together. Flat back, look forward as you inhale. And forward over the legs. Hold it here for a moment. Check what's going on in your hamstrings, in your back. Try to lengthen yourself by relaxing down. With your knees bent, roll all the way up to stand. Sweep the arms up, look up to your thumbs. Then bring the hands to the heart as you exhale, some must be begin. Take a moment here, calm yourself down. Breathe deeply. And again, reach up as you inhale, look up. And fold all the way down, hands towards the floor as you exhale. Come halfway up, inhale, look forward. And take yourself back to a low plank. You can use your knees or just hover into an upward facing dog. You can do a cobra if you prefer, and then pull back into downward facing dog. Right leg reaches up to the sky, breathe in, bring your right knee to your right elbow, swing the knee to the left elbow, and bring it back to the right elbow. Extend the leg behind as you inhale, and place that foot between your hands as you exhale. Look forwards, find your balance, and run the arms by your side. As you inhale, reach the arms. Hold it here, relax the shoulders down a bit as you reach for the fingers. And we want to stretch that left thigh. So think of your hips and bring the frontal hips upwards a bit as you bend the knee until you feel the stretch down the thigh. Then maintain your stability, reach the arms again. Take a deep breath here. Perhaps sink a bit lower. One more breath. Hands on the floor. Step to one leg at all. Come forwards to one legged plank. Bend the elbows one leg at chaturanga. With both feet on the floor, upward facing dog. And pull back, downward facing dog. Same thing, other leg. Left leg reaches up to the sky, inhale. Left knee to the left elbow. Stay forwards, knee goes towards the right. The knee goes towards the left. Extend the leg behind as you inhale. And with control, don't fling, place that foot between your hands. finely balanced. Belly comes up, chest comes up, arms reaching up. Take a deep breath here. Release your hands on your hips. Pull the hips back, bend the right knee, sink down. Now re-extend the arms. Deep breath in. Slow breath out. Another breath in. Step back, one-legged dog. Come forward, one-legged plank, one-legged chaturanga. Upward facing dog, or a cobra as you inhale. And back into downward dog as you exhale. Again, reaching that right leg up as you inhale. This time, bring the knee, the right knee to your left elbow. Swing to the right, and swing to the left. Swing to the right, and swing to the left. And swing it back, inhale, and foot between the hands, exhale. Do a high lunge, reach up. Bend the knee, sink down. Breathe in, now frame the front foot with your hands. Look forward. And start to pull back on that right leg until it is as straight as possible. Look forward, inhale, and release your head down as you exhale. Two breaths. Last breath. And coming up. Bend the knee. Reach back one leg at all. Come forward, plank and chaturanga. Upward facing dog. Back into downward dog as you exhale. Left leg reaches up, breathe in. Left knee to the right elbow. Swing to the left. Swing to the right. Swing to the left. Swing to the right. Extend behind, inhale. Foot to the hands, exhale. High lunge, rise. Bend the knee, sink. Breathe in. Hands to the floor, pull back, punch for Uttanasana. Straighten the front leg as best as you can and relax your head. Yeah. So at home, if you're struggling a bit here, you can have a brick underneath your right hand and the left hand can be on the shin to make it easier, more accessible. If that's still a struggle, simply keep the knee slightly bent and maybe occasionally aim it towards straight and then come out of it. So you can gradually increase that flexibility. But you do it mindfully. Let's come out. Back to downward facing dog with the leg up, one legged dog. Come forward, bend the elbows, chaturanga. Both feet on the floor, upward facing. And then pull back, downward facing dog. Let's take one deep breath in. And as you exhale, bend the knees, look forward. Another step or hop from the mat and fold over the legs. Rise to stand here as you inhale, reach the arms up. And hands to heart, exhale. Okay, stay here, calm yourself down. Let's keep moving. Inhale, reach up. And exhale, forward. Look forward, breathe in. We're going straight to chaturanga. Upward facing as you inhale. Downward facing. Exhale, right leg goes up to the sky, straight away bring it to your hands as you exhale. Into a high lunge, reach up. Hands on the floor, pull back as you exhale. Bend the knee, reach the arms up, inhale. And then open the arms wide. Start to turn the chest towards the back. So if I turn to the other side so you can see better. As you turn, bring the palms together. And bring your left elbow to the outside of your right knee. Hold it here, twist. Press back for that right back heel. And then if you want to, you can reach the arms up. If the hand can reach the floor, bring it to the floor. If it's too much, keep the palms together. One breath here. And then release the hands down. Step back. Downward facing dog. Same thing, other side. Left leg goes up. Left foot to the hands. Through high lunge, reach up as you inhale. And then fold forwards, partial uttanasana. Exhale. Bend the front knee, high lunge, inhale. Start to turn towards the left. Bring the palms together, right elbow outside of left knee. Or bring the hand to the floor and open up. Take a deep breath in. If you want to, you can challenge yourself by looking up. One more breath. And again, for the high lunge, come up as you inhale. And you can take a vinyasa, or you can go straight to downward facing dog. Hold it here for a moment. Calm yourself down. A few more breaths here, let everything settle. Let's start with the left leg. Let's reach the left leg up with the inhalation. And bring the foot all the way to the hands as you exhale. With the right hip on the floor, come up to warrior one as you inhale. Palms together, gaze up to your thumbs. Sink a bit lower. Another breath here. Then open up towards your right, warrior two. Straighten the front leg, reach the arms up as you inhale. Keep the spine in the center as you bend the front knee. Exhale, looking forwards. Again, reach up, breathe in, look up. Bend the front knee, sink down. And one more time, come up as you inhale, look up. Sink down and hold. Breathe. From here we go to Sadhana pose. Reach forwards and bring the hand to the floor against the inside of the foot. Right hand goes up. That's too low. Hand can be on the thigh. Stay here and look up. Then roll the shoulder back. Reach your right hand behind. Catch the inside of your left thigh as best as you can. And start to straighten the left leg. Adjust the left hand. So it's on the leg, then look up. Uttita Trikonasana, with the hand behind the back. Breathing calmly. Bring it up. Keeping the hand behind the back, bend the front knee, go to revolver work. Lean back, open the left side. Take another breath here, then release the hands, cartwheel the hands to the floor. You can go straight to downward facing dog or take a vinyasa. Once you're ready, from downward facing dog, send your right leg up as you inhale and bring the foot all the way to your hands as you exhale, rising to warrior one. Reach your arms up. We're going to change sides so you can see better. Left heel is on the floor, chest is facing forwards, hips are facing forwards. The arms reach up and the gaze is to the thumbs. Sink a bit lower. One more breath. And then straighten the leg and open out. Going for an easy alignment with your heels. Bend the front knee. Reach the arms and look up as you inhale. Again, bend the front knee, look forwards too. Reach up as you inhale. And sink once more and hold. Feel your ribcage pulling back and your belly firming in. One more breath in. Then reach forwards. Forearm on the thigh, hand on the floor, left arm to the sky. Hold it here, open up your chest. Another breath there. Then roll the shoulder. Bring the hand behind your back, and best as you can, catch the inside of the right thigh. Then start to pull back until your right leg is straight. You can hold the big toe, you can have your hand on the foot or on the shin. To come out, bend the front knee, keeping the left hand behind. Reach the right arm up, revolve warrior. and coming out to downward facing dog. So step through your vinyasa. And hold it here. Let's take a deep breath in. And with the exhalation, start to move your hands back to your feet. Feet hip width apart, hands on the shins, look forward as you inhale. And as you exhale, fold. You can hold the back of the legs, you can hold your big toes, or you can place the hands underneath your feet. Either way, look forward as you inhale, and then forward, relax your head. Take a few breaths here. Release your hands, look forward, and walk the hands back to downward facing dog. Hold it here. Then come forward into a plank as you inhale. We'll do a few yogic press-ups. So if you need to, you can drop the knees to the floor, lift the feet up, and keep your torso and thighs in the same line as you bend and come up. Or if you want to, you can do it without the knees. Let's do three. So bend your elbows and inhale. Press back up, three. Bend the elbows, inhale. Come up, two. Bend the elbows, inhale. And come up, three. Hold it here, lift up. Come to the tips of the toes, holding here for five, four, three, two, and one, downward facing dog. Send our right leg up as you inhale. Bring the foot all the way to your hands. Turn towards your left. Parallel the edges of your feet, fingertips on the floor, breathing in, and forward as you exhale, pressure meet up, Paddhatanasana. So hands on the floor, or you can reach to take your feet. Here, come back onto the hands, look forwards. We're going to bend the right knee. Try to lift the chest and look forwards. Okay, wipe the sweat. Then other side. So try to stay as low as you can, shift the weight, walk the hands towards the left. So gradually your inner thigh is getting closer to the floor and the bum and shoulders are roughly the same height. Other side. Then going towards the right. This time try to bring the head towards the floor. Come back up and go to the other side. So walk the hands, bring the head down. Come back to the center and drop both knees, bend both knees, drop your hips down. You can use your elbows to push the knees out. Again, shift towards the right. This time, if you can, lift your left toes and sink back until you are almost on your heel, or maybe on the heel. If the heel is off the floor, you can use the hands like that. If the heel is on the floor and you have the balance, bring the palms to the heart. Stay here, take a few breaths. Then we do the other side. So without coming up and down too much, try to stay low. Go all the way to the other side, straighten your right leg, point the toes up. Use the hands if you need to, keep them at the heart. Back to the center, hands on the floor. Kick the heels up, look forward. And then straighten both legs and fold. So the hands can go further back, head to the floor, or you can reach the arms up, interlace the fingers, take them over towards. If the head is already on the floor, bring your feet a bit closer so you can have a bit more traction with the head hovering. Okay, let's come out. Hands on the floor, look forwards, breathing, and turn towards the right, step to downward facing dog. Okay, let's lift the right leg up to the sky and bring the foot to the hands. Rise into warrior one as you inhale, then open up warrior two. Revolve warrior, inhale, and reach forwards, extend the side angle, exhale, and back to revolve, breathe in, and hands on the floor. Make your way to downward facing dog. Follow the breath, and back in the dog. Left leg reaches up to the sky, breathe in, left foot all the way to the hands. Warrior one, rise, open up warrior two. Revolve warrior, inhale, extend the side angle, exhale. Full revolve, breathe in, and again we're taking a big lesson. Following the breath. One more time, right leg reaches up, right foot to the hands. Warrior one, rise. Warrior two, open. Revolve warrior, inhale. Extend inside ankle, exhale. Full revolve, breathe in. Now hold it here. Use your left hand to hold the right wrist and pull further. Straighten the right leg. One more breath in and then come out. So one more time with the left side. So straight the downward facing dog. Left leg goes up. Left foot to the hands. Warrior one, right. Open warrior two. Revolve warrior, breathe in. Side angle pose, breathe out. For revolve warrior, breathe in. Now hold. Grab your left wrist, pull out, and straighten left leg. One last breath. Bend the knee. Hands on the floor. One more time, step it down with the seat. Center the breath. Reach your right leg up as you inhale. Bend the knee and open up your hip. You can stay here or slowly bring your toes towards the floor and then arch back, lift your right arm up or take it all while thinking. Take one more breath. Hand on the floor. Reach the right leg up and bring the knee to your hands. Settle the shin down and settle yourself down. Lift the heart up as you breathe in. And forward pigeon pose. Right here. And slowly coming up. Lean towards the right and bring your left leg forward. The right foot against the inside of the left thigh. Sweep the arms up as you inhale, turn forwards, and bring your belly towards the thigh, bring your forehead towards the shin. Slowly come up. I'm going to place the right ankle above the left knee, bend the left knee, and place the left foot underneath the right. So the shins are stacked this way. If that is impossible and you cannot sit in or like that, bring your right foot in front. So the shins are parallel in front of each other, feet and knees are the same line. So either choose to sit up with this one. Fold. If you find 5 breaths here. As much as you can, try to extend the heart, relax the shoulders. And then we're coming up. So turning, crossing the shins, bring the hands by your side. Do a few things here. The first option is to press the feet and lift up your hips, your bum. The second option is to lean back and lift up your feet. The third option is to lean forwards and lift up both. So hold it here, 3, 2, and 1, release. Either tuck the feet, bring the hands forwards, step back,